A big thanks to all of my Patreon supporters. And a big thanks to all of these donators of $5 or more. Dead Zergling, Radio Raptor, Vlad Tepish 3176, and Brian D0313. You all helped make these episodes possible. Howdy, Insufferable Gaming fans. Your old pal Rosser here. And today, we are playing some more Zanac. Last time, we didn't make a damn lick of progress in Area 8. Area 8's pretty tough, but I'm sure it's doable, so it's gonna be more of the same. I'm gonna try like hell to figure out the best method to get through this. Now, that being said, I have gotten some insight, such as getting that first triple shot, possibly destroying the red Metroid things when convenient. It's very difficult not to automatically run straight at them to try to get them out of the way immediately, even when that would cause problems for me. It's mostly instinct, you see. And instinct is a very dangerous thing in a game like this. You really have to think of things more rationally and thoughtfully, with a focus on dodging. Well, that was a life right off the bat. Aww. Made some pretty good progress before losing that first life, so that's cool. And that wasn't. But we need this. We absolutely need that. See, now we have the super weapon, which is very necessary. And now we don't have the super weapon. Because, of course, things come in from the damn side of the screen and ruin my life. They do that, you know. They're like, hey, is that Rosser over there? One pixel to the right of where we're gonna make our entrance? let's mess him up. That'll be cool, man. Everyone's gonna love that. It'll be hilarious. Give me a five. Got five. Okay, good. I would like some more fives, but kind of hard to reach everything with all of this weirdness floating around the screen. But I did manage to get it, so that's one bonus that we've got going for us. If I can just dodge all these... Damn, I couldn't dodge all them bullets. Because of the red troids. They sure are buttholes, those things are. Always blocking my bullets and being on screen and looking like moving objects that are going to cause my death. And distracting me from the real enemies. Well, I guess they are technically real enemies, but you know what I mean. You all know exactly what I meant by that. This level sucks. I mean, the other levels also sucked, but this one also sucks. I don't much care for it. No, sir. Oh, right. Get that. I should probably just hammer the fire button at all times, because it doesn't seem like I'm preventing any enemy fire from increasing in its scale by not... I should just take out the blood Metroids immediately upon seeing them, but I know that's gonna get me wrecked eventually. It's only a matter of time, really, before that bites me in the ass. Ah, shizen. Well, we can still pull this off, maybe. I hope. So many things happening all at once, all around the screen. Absolute nightmare. Okay. Ah! Ballsack. If I could just keep that, like, past the initial shock of everything that's on screen when I get it, it'd be so much simpler. Alas. Hasn't happened yet. And that ruined my life a bit. Whoa, 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 whoa! Whoa, 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 whoa. Frickin' red droids. They really need to just piss right the hell off. The whole lot of them. They're causing me untold mental frustration. Psychological damage. Fear. Superstition. What can I get for another 5? Seems like this is as far as they upgrade, perhaps. Actually, these red droids are keeping these things reapplying themselves every few seconds, which is actually pretty helpful because it keeps them close enough to take out enemy bullets, so this could be a new strategy for this level, all things considered. I mean, it's ugly as sin, but it's working, kind of. So what's the catch? There's always a catch. Always. Always much pain to be had. Whoa, 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 whoa! Jeez! Asshead holes! I'm running on pure Twitch reflex right now, and it's only doing half a job because, man, a lot of this is just getting lucky with my weapon blocking the bullets. An inordinate amount, I would say, is just that. See, like right there. I probably should have taken a hit. Pure damn luck. But I'll take it. Okay. We're at a thing. I just gotta not get shot. Which, easier said than done. Kill those mofos. All of them. Get them, get them. Whoa! That could have been a damn disaster, and might still be. Give it time. Son of a bitch! There's more bullets than anyone can focus on in this. Jeesh. Oh, thank goodness I made it through the level. God, that was painful. Here's the bad news. I don't know what's waiting for me. If there are any weapons that are worth getting. Well, there's a 3. That would have been nice. That would have been great. Would have loved to have had that. That would have... Hello! Okay! Well, there's definitely, sub-weapons to be had, so that's not a concern. What is a concern? Whether or not I can actually survive long enough to use them. Completely different question. It could very well be out of the question, we don't know yet. We've got Swirly Mabobs, everybody's favorite enemy. Let's get rid of those if we are able to do such a thing. Ah! My eyes started itching and I blinked. You can't blink. You can't blink in Zanac. It's not a feasible thing to do. Never has been. Alright, you. Get shot. That wasn't a hard one. That was actually quite pleasant. course, that was only the first area. Oh good, one of these. Haven't seen one of those in a while. And I was kind of glad that I hadn't. See, if I had sub-weapons, this would be a piece of cake. Well, if I had good sub-weapons. But when do we ever have good sub-weapons this far in? Oh, there we go. Gimme, gimme, gimme. Yes. Beautiful. Aww. That was a good start, though. We have proof of concept for Area 9. I won't have to start the whole game over to get through Area 9 because it has sub-weapons. Thought it was the right one. Maybe I was an idiot that read the situation incorrectly. I mean, wouldn't be the first time that's happened. I really wish that I'd gotten that stuff. Nope. The right is not correct. Very well then. Like, maybe it's the middle. Maybe it's just not the same one every time in this case. Bye, number three. So long, buddy. I'll miss you. Okay, we've got another five. Fives are pretty good for the way I've been using them thus far, so we're just gonna keep this zipping along, shall we? Oh yeah, I think so. Number five, you're an absolute monster. You're doing the Lord's work. Need to get a little closer. Hell yeah. Man. I underestimated number five in the past. It's very respectable. Then again, you get here and, you know, these things. They really cause some problems now, don't they? Was that a super weapon station back there that I spied just out of the corner of my eye? I don't know. Ugh, I hate this part. There. That did not kill it. Lots of things didn't kill things in this situation. We got swirly mabobs. Oh, the swirly mabobs. And this thing is blocking the things that are shooting at me, which is a pretty good defense mechanism, isn't it? Evil fortress. Once more. Again. Okay, it was the middle again that time, so not enough booze at the liquor store. Double fives! I want the double fives. Give me the double fives! I missed! Damn you, game! You've screwed me! Fine, I'll take a three. And I hope you appreciate what I have sacrificed to go with a three instead. Especially since this isn't 100% effective in terms of safety. But then again, what is 100% effective in the terms of safety? Not that damn thing, that's for sure. So much better when I got the double fives. Can we achieve double fives again? And yeah, it looks like it's the middle one. For the most... Fuck! Why is that so difficult for me to handle? I would love to know the answer to the... Bugger. Oh yeah, that's exactly what I meant to get right there, buddy. Yeah, a forward-facing shield. That'll save my life. I mean, it might. I don't know for sure. It probably won't. Because, you know, it's almost completely destroyed now, but... I guess it was nice to have for a little bit. Okay, at the start, and here's the issue that I find. At the start of the level, before I get any weapons, there's this set of three turrets that shoot in a very rapid pattern, and I need to make it through that before anything else. That seems to be my sticking point thus far. If I can make it through that without dying, I can pick up a three shield, or I can wait and pick up some dual fives. Or possibly a four. A four might do the trick as well. Now, did I see a super weapon upgrade somewhere here, vaguely on the right side of the screen before? That's something I can't confirm yet. Like, I probably didn't, but I'm gonna keep an eye out. Ah, shit. Still keeping that eye out. Nope. I guess I was wrong, because I didn't see one. Oh, and there's a number one right there. Not that number one is a great find. I might go for the number four, because that does a fantastic job of, like, locking things that are right ahead of you! Okay. The problem with the three, though, is that it doesn't hit ground-based targets, and that'll make it really hard to get this stuff up here. Whew! A six! What is a six again? Oh, right! The kill everything button. I should have kept that a little bit longer. What happened to the four? I guess I just flat out didn't, pick it up, or knock it loose, or whatever. Damn. I need double fives if I'm gonna do anything with the fives, really. Clearly, this was not the run. Again! Again! Ha ha! Oh, I see what happened. What I thought was a super thing was actually just a busted turret that kind of looks like a super power-up. But it's not. It's a broken-ass turret. No, 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 no! Get the hell out of my face! Enemies! No one likes your style. Okay, double fives. Good start. Good start. Now just don't piss away all the goodwill. Don't ruin this chance, me. You have an opportunity here. A fantastic opportunity. To do great progress. Just make it through this bullet storm. Alright, good, 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 good. Okay, that was the easy part. Now there are so very many hard parts that I find myself less than optimistic about my chances, but through the fire and the flames, we carry on. Shit, we didn't carry on far enough. Obvi-fuckin-ously. I hate this bastard. He causes me so much frustration. Yeah, that's what I thought. Why you not dead? Now you dead. If I could only get past this section, I would at least get to see what's past this section. Which, you know, could be anything, really. Motherfucker came right out of the left side of the screen there. What the hell, game? Was this designed to be an arcade game? Because I feel like I would have used an awful lot of fucking quarters by now if it was. Well, at least you'd have got your money's worth if you'd bought this game back when it came out. Because it's certainly not something that you beat in one sitting. I can say that about it. You know, if I had a Super 7, this wouldn't be a problem. But I haven't got a Super 7. I haven't seen a Super 7 since way earlier in the game. Really? Shit weasels. A 7! Holy shit, it's a 7. Could I have gotten that at any time? Because seriously, I could have really used that sooner. I should probably try saving some of it. If I can take this 7 to the second boss, it'll be a no-brainer. 7 is just the best. Except for Super 7, which is even bester. Joe Bester. The slightly off version of that other stooge that no one talks about. If this guy doesn't kill me, though, because that could very much happen. Shit, 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 shit! I fucking hate this enemy. It has done everything in its power to ruin my life. And it's still not dead yet. I mean, that's cool, right? It's just still hanging out during the boss fight, hovering about, doing its diagonal little jigs and jabs and shooting curly bullets. How do you even get a bullet to curve? Is this fucking X versus Sever or some ridiculous shit like that? You can't curve a bullet except by gravity. I mean, maybe if you shot one in hurricane force winds and it traveled like a mile, it would curve like an inch. But seriously. Well, this'll have to do. Like I say, you take what you can get, right? It's no number 7, but at least it'll protect me from a series of bullets. As long as I dodge the best I can. Now, if I had a level 2... Yeah, there we go. I was gonna say regular gun. And lo and behold, there it is. I might even make it to level 3 before this is over. Shit, didn't see that until the last second. You know, Joe Besser, the other stooge that wasn't Shimp or Curly, he was like, "You big crazy!" That guy. He was in a few episodes, I think. I should go back and rewatch a lot of Three Stooges. You know, I like really cerebral stuff, but I also just really love flat-out dumbass slapstick. It makes me laugh harder than anything else. Just physical comedy. There's something about it that I really love. And I get it. A lot of people think that it's ridiculous and base, but hey, if it makes you laugh, it makes you laugh. I'm not gonna defend my tastes. I know I have crass tastes. I apologize for nothing. Ah. There's gotta be an easier way to get rid of that fucker. Hell if I can figure it out. Oh, leave me the hell alone, guy. I'm gonna need a good sub-weapon, probably fives to get rid of that guy. No, fives weren't really doing it. Maybe if I got a really solid six. And kept it for as long as possible. We'll see what shakes out of the woodworks. And that was useless because I blew one up. Really? Really, truly, really, truly. Yep. Yep. Okay, four is good. Four is good. Don't lose the four. Don't lose the four. Four is frickin' fantastic. Probably could have used to drop it off at a different portion of the screen, sure. Might need to get a little higher up. There we go. Just be careful. That's the main thing. This could be a game changer. Or it could get me killed. I guess we'll find out. Okay, just gotta get around these. There we go. Excellent. Four is good for this level, I think. Now here's the problem. It's not gonna hit that thing. That frickin' thing. It's the worst thing. Yep, there it goes. Just get rid of it! Kill it! I did as much damage as I could before my invincibility wore off. That's really all you can ask. Now here's the problem. I've still got this guy to deal with. Back! Edit! This is Aliyuk! Vincent enough for you! Shit. Play the elegy of my people there, game. Alright. Once more into the breach. And wasted that. Wasted that life. Those enemies wasted me. I just need to get more of a spread going on the screen here. Seven! Oh, seven, don't fail me now. Stay with me forever and be my friend. 'Cause you're my best friend. I mean, you wouldn't think that numbers could be your friends unless you were some kind of math nerd. Which we've established in the fact that I am many kinds of nerds, but math is not one of them. Oh, why? I wasn't paying enough attention. Curse my rotten hide. There's a lot of those now. I'd be much obliged if there were fewer attacking me. There we go. That did the trick! Kind of amazed I've kept this one going this long. I expected that to kill me a lot faster. Death Blossom! It's not effective here. Really, nearly nowhere is that effective. Leastways in this game. Now a Gin Blossom. I can get behind that. Ah. You're still not exploded yet? Come on, man. You're not impressing anyone! Just being a dick. Maybe I should take out these edge... Right, that's why you don't stay on the edge for this fight. Of course. What was I thinking? Well, looks like that's my time, and we did make some progress, so I guess I will see you next time, is what I would say if I hadn't promised to do a double episode. So, we are going to just go for another period here. We're gonna keep trying. May God have mercy on my sanity. So, I mean, on the one hand, it does mean that while we're doing this, it'll be easier to keep muscle memory and shit like that going. Who knows, maybe I can even get a double 3 or something. I want that 4. Out of all of these things, the 4 seems like it's my best bet. For now. You can do it. Icarette can help. I wish I could start smoking again. Unfortunately, it ain't allowed around here. I like smoking. Made me feel better. But, I mean, it was kind of killing me slowly. But I knew the risks going in, dammit. I'm not one of those people that blames the tobacco companies, because my entire life, you know, from when I was going to school in the 80s, everybody was always telling you smoking is bad for you. And I knew that. It's just very relaxing. And I'm probably gonna get hit with the cancer stick anyway, because everyone in my family's had it. Really? Oh, I'm still alive? Color me impressed. Right. Firecrackers. Ah! We started out that one so strong. This one, not so much. This is not going to be one of the great. Yep, not going to be one of the greats. Unless I get a double 7. I bet this thing could drop a double 7 if I get really good RNGs. I have no idea what I just picked up. Oh, okay, now I know. This could wreck the shit out of that giant monster. Potentially. But I'm not gonna be able to keep it that long, unfortunately. Alas. This also means that I didn't get any of the other, like, really great weapons that I kinda needed. Huge problem, that. Yeah, whatever you do, don't hit the base. Ah! Blast and bother. What assness? Assness is a word. I have decreed it. Double assness. Banzai! Yeah, take that, enemy base. Bet you didn't see that coming. You may think you've won, but have fun picking pilot guts out of your intake valves. Assholes. Can we? Please, just make it... Nope. Pass the first wave without taking a death. I could not. Not this time, anyway. Okay. There's a 7. Let's, use up some of these bombs first. Okay. Should be clear sailing till the boss. Don't waste all of the actual ammo. There's a life. Make up for the one that I inevitably lose at the start of this level every single time, which is... obnoxious, at best. Insulting, at worst. Now can I please, please focus and not get hit by things coming in from the side of the screen, which is what has caused me to lose my 7 laser every single time thus far. Side of the... Fuck me right up the goat ass. I don't think the 7 laser is, within my jurisdiction to keep. You know, it's like a baby animal. If you love it, set it free. If it comes back, it was yours. If it doesn't, then it never was to begin with. Or something like that. Wonder what happened to those ducks that we let go. I mean, they were probably old enough to fly. But yet they never left their pen. Which they easily could have. But man, did they make a mess. Ducks are very messy. Hi, I'm Ross, and I can't get to the first damn set of power-ups without losing a life, because I'm an asshole. Fives. Eh. Ooh, triple twos. Let's do that. Fuck you, guys. Aw, no! I thought the triple twos would be better. I was wrong. I was horribly, horribly wrong. Back. Damn it. Let's just stand right here and move the bare minimum of distance back and... Yeah, that didn't work. It was worth a shot. I thought maybe I was overthinking it. Maybe I just needed to make minimal adjustments. Alas, that was not the case. I needed to make grand sweeping dodging gestures. And before you ask, no, I'm not drunk already. I just started drinking, so I've only just got a light buzz. Which is the perfect place you want to be in a game like this. Well, I missed all of those, so maybe I was wrong about that after all. Damn it. This is... not good. You know that thing that's the opposite of good? What's it called? Bad? Yeah. Bad. That's the term I would have used for that. I think we can all agree to that. Yeesh. Where the hell are those golden bastards coming from? Uranus? I bet they're coming from Uranus. Not your anus, but someone's anus. Probably the developers. They're like, well, this game is too easy, let's pull something out our butt. Make it a little bit harder. And thus that enemy was born. As a last-ditch effort to make sure that this game, that's not in an arcade, and doesn't take quarters, would take more quarters, because that's how game developers thought back then. I mean, it doesn't behoove them any, but they do it anyway, because that's how things were done at the time. I guess he just had to be there. You will not sink this putt, you jackass! Truly, the jackass in this case was I. Okay. Ooh, are those double sevens or a one and a seven? It was a one and a seven, alas. Well, nonetheless. All I have to do is not fuck up the seven when I get to the space station enemy. If I could keep it to the second fortress, I will be able to beat it. It's just that little bit of time in between that gets me every time, which is unfortunate. It shouldn't be that hard, but it is for some reason. Hang on a second. Hang on. You know what this needs? This needs to get my tackle box full of interesting fish lures into the equation. Yes, indeed. Let me go grab that real quick. When I was just a kid, my dad gave me his old tackle box. It's beat to shit, and it's seen better days. But I need a totem. A lucky charm, if you will. And I have lucky charms here in my tackle box of strange and mysterious lures. It's kind of hard to get you to see it, but I should probably turn off the filter on the camera that makes all the green go away. So I will. There we go. But yeah, got lots of neat fishing lures and stuff in here. But there's one that I save for a very special occasion. And that is the crawdad. It's seen better days. It's been lost many a time, and I've had to retrieve it from the depths of many a chug hole and a tree. But this is the lucky lure that once I caught two smallmouth bass at once, twice in one fishing trip. Twice in one fishing trip, I caught two smallmouth bass, one on each hook, at the same time. And not tiny little smallmouth bass either, like good-sized smallmouth bass. So, I'm getting this one out. It will be my gross-looking little lucky charm for the rest of this episode. Hopefully it will give me the luck I need. See if I can autofocus on that. Yeah, look at that. Crawdad, baby. I'm just gonna hang that right here on me pocket. Alright. that nonsense and superstition out of the way, we should continue, shouldn't we? And thus, we do. Oh! Not getting luckies thus far. But then, we've only done a bare minimum of attempts. I don't need no stinking extra firepower. Yeah! What? And the sevens. Good, good. So far, so good. I mean, I'm sure it'll all go to shit on me, but I like to imagine that I have a chance. That is key. Watch out for the meteors. So many meteors. Thanks, Lucky Lure. You know, I haven't actually caught anything fishing in, like, over 5 years, so it's possible the luck has... you know what? I know exactly why the luck has worn off. So let me tell you a fishing story. You know, before that fishing trip, where I caught 2 sets of smallmouth bass in 1 trip that were both 2-on-1 lure... Before that, I had had an accident with that lure, and that accident involved me missing a cast, and the lure actually whipped back and caught on my cheek. And then, when it caught on my cheek, I flinched my head to the right, and that caught on my shirt. So, I had this treble hook lure caught to my shirt, which was also caught to my cheek, so my head was stuck to my shirt. There was nothing I could do to pull it out. Not safely. So, after a while, I finally sucked up my misgivings, and mind you, I was like 12 or 13 years old at the time. And I said, you know what? I just gotta go for it. And I just ripped my cheek violently to the right, pulling the lure out of my cheek, but not my shirt. So, from that day on, the lure, it actually had this chunk of human cheek skin on it for years. It had a piece of my cheek stuck to the lure. And those were the years when I caught the most fish, when I had a piece of my cheek stuck to it, just like this little dried piece of leathery human flesh. But eventually, it kind of fell off over time. And I haven't really had any good luck with that lure since it came off, so maybe the secret ingredient to that lure was actually human suffering. Now, maybe this is worth pursuing. And maybe it isn't. But I'm not gonna deliberately hurt myself to find out. I've had enough pain in my life. I don't need any more, man. Chronic bursitis is bad enough. I mean, I'm batshit insane in the head, but not that batshit insane. I've got better things to do than do Frankenstein-y experiments. Damn. I felt like I was closer that time. Maybe not. Try not to blow up. Son of a bitch, I blew up! Hey, I think I see a pattern where I can get rid of those things. What have I got? Oh. Bombs. Lame. Great any other time, except when you're trying to get rid of fortresses. You know what? Considering what I've got going for me in the weapons department, I should probably just try to dodge. That might be the best thing for me, honestly. I don't have a whole lot of options here. Plus, maybe if I can keep the bombs, I can kill that big guy. The big diagonal X dude with the eyeball. You know the one. The one that has given me trouble non-stop since this level began. But hey, I did get to this level, right? I mean, that's progress. That's undeniably progress. Every little bit helps. It's a massive ego boost. Not much to say here. Not even gonna fire at it, because what's the point? When I start moving, I need to dodge the bullets on either the left or the right, so I need to pay attention to the timer. Or I need to be, like, on the opposite side of wherever the stuff is shooting from. Okay, good, 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 good. Yes! Now. Fuck you. That bounced off. Really? That bounced off. Well, that was a ginormous waste of my fucking time, wasn't it, game? I'm glad we had this little experiment in weapon usage. No, really, that was great. Can't wait for the next one. Really need to get that triple shot at the beginning. Ah! No! 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 I don't need it! I don't want it! Wait a minute. I somehow wound up with a 7. Shit fire and save matches. I'm legitimately dizzy. Say, Dead Zergling. Is the reason you wanted me to play this game because you knew the later levels would make my life a living hell? Because that's adorable. You did a great job picking this one, man. Look. I may be furious, but I know what makes good viewing when I see it, and this is gonna be it. This is certainly gonna do that. Because holy shit, this is making me flip my shit. And that's what people wanna see. Your AVGNs, your Super Mario frustrations, etc. Thanks for that. Ah! I can't get away from this cock blaster. There goes the last of my booze. I hope you're satisfied. I didn't think I was gonna make it through the whole thing in one episode, but there we have it. Wow. That's super effective versus the boss. Not! Oh, bet you didn't think that the 90s were coming back, did you? But I said not! See, it's like Wayne's World. Yeah. Everybody loves Wayne's World. Actually, I do really love Wayne's World. Both the skit and the movie. I really enjoyed it. Because it involved Dana Carvey, who is my all-time favorite SNL actor. And I don't say that lightly, because there are a lot from that era that were really great. But, Dana Carvey was the one that was doing stuff during the time when I was, like, watching SNL and Young and Impressionable, so... You know, him, Mike Myers, you know, I also like Chris Farley and Adam Sandler. I remember back when Adam Sandler used to make funny movies. Those were good times. Tina Fey, Jerry O'Terry. The black guy? Well, shit. I'm gonna feel like crap if I don't remember his name, too. The ladies' man, Leon Phelps. See, I got distracted. That's what happens. I could have told you if I hadn't have been trying to think of it. You know that, right? Alas. That happened to me earlier today, too. Like, fuck. I went downstairs, right? Like, I was going downstairs for something, and I couldn't remember what. And, like, I knew I was going downstairs for a reason, but I got halfway downstairs, and I forgot what I was going downstairs for. So I got down there, and I was like, surely I'll remember it if I just look around. Well, I didn't. Not until 3 hours later. Alright, use this for a bit, and I'm dead. I had a four, you know, if I could just get it to drop, like, 3 sevens in a row, that'd be great. But that's very RNG heavy. God damn it. I'm not doing any better. It's gaming fatigue that sets in, you know. Like, you do really well for a while, and then all of a sudden, you start making simple mistakes. Everybody's had it happen. Everybody who's been gaming long enough, anyway. Tim Meadows! Yes! Tim Meadows kicks ass. Ha ha! Ah, thank God. That would have driven me crazy. And I can't just look up on Google in the middle of a video. It was incumbent on me to remember it using my brain mind. And now I have. I'll tell you some other people that I wish hadn't retired from acting. Rick Moranis. He was great. I loved him as Lord Helmet. Also, a lot of the SNL alumni that died were some of my favorites, like Chris Farley. And other people that died that I really liked include John Candy. Actually, most of the actors that I like have, you know, well, 2016 has been really rough for actors and musicians. Let's just put it that way and leave it at that. You know, Gene Wilder was the most recent one. Double Sevens? Oh, I wish that had done more. And I saw something poignant on Facebook that I'd like to put out there. I love Mel Brooks, even before he's dead. Like, I mentioned this in an episode which may or may not get uploaded before this. I'm not sure because I have no idea what my schedule looks like these days. It's been a mess. I can't say I was the biggest Gene Wilder fan in the world, but I did love everything that I remember him from. Now, Mel Brooks. He is one of my favorite actors, and I will say that right now, before it's too late. So that's going to be particularly hard for me. And as far as musicians go, I'm going to take it really hard when Alice Cooper goes. Can I not keep a number 7 through this? At all? I guess not. Arrakis! Motherfucker. I got to see Alice Cooper in concert. He was touring with Rob Zombie in the Halloween Havoc tour. It was damn awesome, I assure you. So double sevens don't get me any extra 7 juice. Interesting to know. I mean, it would have been great if it had. But alas. Well, that didn't... Well, it did help. That got me a 7 again. Where the hell did you come from, Mr. 7? Mr. 7 of 8? That's a Borg joke. Everybody loves Borg jokes, right? Oh, wait. They count 0. 0 is also an option in this game, so I guess that really was 7 of 9. Which is a reference to one of the worst Star Treks. Ah! I'm gonna fucking spike this controller into the ground and shatter it to pieces and stick the pieces up my urethra from sheer anger. Was it that hard, me, to just finish that boss? Yeah, anyway, Star Trek Voyager sucked. Enterprise sucked. The original series was great. The Next Generation was great after the first season. And DS9 was fucking transcendental after the first couple of seasons. That's what I'm gonna say about Star Trek. You know, I originally didn't get on board with Deep Space Nine because I couldn't really catch it at a reasonable time and I didn't have cable. But man, once I actually was able to stream the whole series, I couldn't put it down. It was legitimately one of the best series I've ever seen in terms of character development and plot lines. And I dearly love TNG and the original series. So, take that for what it's worth. If you need any Star Trek recommendations, watch the original series, watch TNG. If you don't have time, you can probably skip the first season and go from there, and then Deep Space Nine. Which you could probably skip the first season of that too, but it sets up a lot of important plot elements. So, you know, you kind of gotta watch it. Damn it. Oh, there's a bullet. So many bullets. I should dodge more bullets more often. Oh man, that's the strategy I should use to beat this level. Dodge all the bullets. Why didn't I think of that sooner? See, that's the kind of forward thinking that we need. And that's the kind that I just failed. I did not dodge all the bullets. And also, I'm burping up a lot of interesting flavors because I just made myself a lunch smoothie that involved lots of baby spinach and kale and frozen fruit and cranberry juice. I'm trying to eat more healthy, alright? And I hate it. I absolutely hate it. A fruit smoothie does not satisfy my hunger for red meat, which I have in abundance. I am, at heart, a huge carnivore. There's not a whole lot I can do about it. Just, you know, just my own particular biology. Maybe brain chemistry? I don't feel satisfied unless I've had, like, some chicken or steak or something. Doesn't even have to be, like, a full compliment. Just, you know, even a little bit. Or you know what else will do the trick? Cheese. Like, if I can have some nachos, that'll do the trick every time. Lots of bread, lots of cheese, lots of meat. Vegetables and fruits, not so much, but by God, I am trying my best to change that. I'm gonna have to. I mean, I'm not getting any younger. And you know, I take vitamins every morning, but it's not completely functional. Okay, here comes the dude. Here comes that fucking thing that's gonna ruin my life again. Ah! Laysai. How am I going to figure this out? I feel like that's endemic to my problem. Is endemic the right term? I'm not sure how to use it. I don't think that's quite right, but anyway, the point is, I gotta figure out how to make this shit work. And I haven't done it yet. I haven't done it this time either. How do I do this? This is 12 pounds of ass in a 5-pound ass gasket. Ass gasket being a unit of pressure, which is why, you know, or ass being a unit of pressure, which is why you would need to use a gasket. You know, there's water pressure and there's ass pressure. And to, like, secure the pressure of your ass, you need to use an ass gasket. I want that 7. I kind of need it. There we go. Okay. I mean, a 4 is great and all, but it won't help me when it comes to that goddamn monster on the second half of the level. Or second, well, not that that did me any better. Anyway, the second stretch of the level. We need a name for that monster. I want to say Monster X, but that's like Mechagodzilla, right? Or is it King Ghidorah? or Disentroya. I don't know. Anyway, mull it over, guys. Figure it out, and we'll try to beat this next time. Until then, this is your old pal Rosser. Take a drink.